Hey folks, Nick here recapping the day. I'm going to do it quickly because it doesn't matter what happened today almost because of tomorrow. Tomorrow is a binary event, the most important Fed event. It always is the most important Fed event. And it will dictate how markets will react, how markets will react and where they will go this week and next couple weeks. So what happened today? If I'm looking at the scoreboard, it's a split decision, meaning the Dow down 128 points, that's minus 0.71. The SPX down 7 points at minus 0.34. NASDAQ is up 0.12, up 5 points, not much. And the small caps are up the biggest, up 0.2 almost. The NASDAQ greenery depended on a handful of stocks. First, let me tell you that this is the Russell 2000, which is up the most. It's broad. Everybody's up. When you go to the NASDAQ, big up day on Apple, up 1.7, almost 1.8%. Same, actually 1.9% on Facebook. Microsoft up 0.55. These guys are insanely up. Regeneron, Alexion, up 3.5 and 3, actually 3.6 and 3.3. Biogen, IDEC up one. So again, biotech, Facebook, Yahoo, pharmaceutical, and Adobe. So a handful affecting. So these two would put the NASDAQ in the red. If you flatten these, don't make them red, just flatten them, NASDAQ would have closed red. The S&P, look, I mean, it's red all over except for these two. So there is hidden weakness, is what I'm saying. S&P 500, again, zooming out, same class of people, Regeneron, Alexion, and these two. So a handful are hiding some weakness. I say that, but then the Russell 2000 tells me a different story. In fact, let's go straight there. The Russell 2000, I believe, hit a new high, all-time high today. On the RUT, this is the all-time high from recent times, and it was 1243.33. Today's high is 1243. Oh my gosh, 0.334. We have to go to the 1,000th of the digit in order to get a new high, but it is here, technically. Not so on the IWM. I think IWM exactly matched it. The high here was, here meaning 3.2, not too long ago, 123.78. The high today, 123.78. So they match the all-time high. So here's a scenario you will probably hear if we fall. If we sell off from there, there'll be talk of double tops. And people say, oh my gosh, double tops mean much more downside. So that alone will invite more selling. But that all depends on what happens tomorrow with the Fed event. So speaking of which, so what happens tomorrow? What are we expecting tomorrow with the Fed event? The market's still closing right now. I've explained it to death. They're going to say something, and the markets are going to react. And nobody can forecast what the heck happens. It all depends on what they say and if they keep the silly word in or out, patient, and how the markets will perceive it. And they might baby us. They might say, we're taking the word out, but we are not going to raise in 2 months necessarily unless the data tells us so. If they say that, then markets might be okay with them taking it out. Now, I'm a little confused because today, let's look at the bonds and the rates, because if I wanted to read into tomorrow, this is the 10-year rate, and they dropped today almost down 2%, okay? So first of all, technically speaking, is this green line going to be support again, like it was here and here? If so, then they might bounce up. But if we're expecting them to take out the word patient tomorrow, wouldn't rates jump ahead of time? That's the logical thing. So could I infer from this that indeed they expect to keep the word in tomorrow, they as in the traders? So tomorrow the surprise is to the downside? One theory, okay? But I'm not going to second guess it. I'm just going to wait and see what happens as opposed to trying to write the movie before it happens. Let's just watch the movie and see what happens. That's why I don't have anything on the line too closely tight. That's why I said I'm sitting on my hands until tomorrow. After the move tomorrow, we can set a trade if we want to, knowing the outcome of the movie. So that's what I like to do. Today, conversely, the bond market was up strong. And I said, you know, this area could be attained again. So now 130 is the next breakout potential. And it just only takes another day like today, and it'll be up in the 130 area. We're setting higher lows and higher highs for a breakout. Will this become, which was prior support, Will it become, and it broke right here, will it become resistance? Doesn't look like it. We closed just above it. But this is not a scientifically drawn line, so I could have missed the actual drawing of the line, but it still looks like a bullish move, which is bad for markets usually. However, yesterday I said I gave up on trying to tie the two together. All right, so let's look at the S&P via the SPY. A red candle today on less volume than yesterday, so people are hesitant to do anything. It's in the middle of the range, the red and the green. It's close towards closer to this green one here, which was a recent top from before, this green threat. So, but it's still indecisive. You know, they tried to sell it, they tried to buy it, but then they closed it right around where they opened it. We'll look at the Qs, the NASDAQ. Same story, still upwards, halfway, you know, still abiding by this support line right here. But again, what happens tomorrow will carry us through the next few days. We may want to re-challenge this. So the bulls want to run. However, they're very hesitant to do it. The only one that is not as hesitant are the small caps, and the broader indices are not joining the fight. Apple, we cannot not mention Apple today. Massive day, gapped up, they decided they want to take it and run with it. And I don't know if it's the TV service, because the TV service news came out earlier and the move didn't happen until just before the open, I think. So regardless, fantastic day for Apple, very strong. Too hot for me to chase, too high for me to chase, too hot for me to short. I'm in no man's land with Apple. So I'm not embarrassed to say that I don't want to trade it right now. We have had quite the action in that name, but it's nowhere near its recent highs. If you remember, it was 133, correct? And from which it fell precipitously. And here we are back to this level right here. So is it that impressive? I'm not sure. What's it going to do now? That's the important part. Okay. So if markets sell off, it won't be immune. It will sell off less maybe, because usually it's perceived as value, but having so many new longs in it, will they be shaken out? All right, there are a few points that I wrote down that I thought I would share with you. Around 11 o'clock, which is around here, there was a point in time right here where everything was like green, strong green, out of the blue. I'm not sure what triggered it, but right here I marked it. Boom, boom, boom. It was all synchronized. See, right here, right here. And it's true here and here. This is the NASDAQ, and these are the small caps. So there were some moves, and I can't explain them why or why not. Everybody's meandering until tomorrow. They're wasting time until tomorrow, they as in the traders. All right, so the heat map tells me that there was some hidden weaknesses. That's the bottom line. All right, Google ended up the day redder than it should have, or the bulls wanted to. It showed weakness in the morning, really weakness, and then rebounded really strong, and then closed weak. Same for Priceline. However, Priceline held higher, meaning it showed real weakness in the morning, down to 1144, and then it went up to 1158 almost in no time, and then closed around 55. So red, yes, but could have been much worse, so still hope for Priceline. There are a couple of other tickers I wanted to see here. Oil, first of all. Oh, my. So the oil play today was sell, sell, buy, buy, sell, sell. Down to 42 and change, ramp up at the open, sell back down, ramp up during the day, close back down 1.7%. It's a rigged market. Stop trying to game it. I did. Okay. So more downside in oil? Who knows? One of our members, Jake, suggested that maybe a deal in Iran would actually put more pressure on oil, because Iran can put out more and sell more of its oils and more supply, lower prices. Very valid. Okay. What am I going to look at here? The ranges, we already talked about that. All-time highs, blah, blah, blah. Netflix, Google, Priceline, Apple, and XLF. Those are the ones I wanted to talk about. Netflix, somebody asked me this morning about Netflix, and, you know, I see, last time I told you that if it loses this red area, and look where it is right now, this could be next. I mean, that's a doom scenario. Why? Because there's this open gap, and markets like to, it's like a vacuum area. as soon as price gets close to it, sucks it right into it. Because nothing happened here. They want to trade it. Nothing happened. They traded here, and then whoosh, up to here. They didn't get the chance to trade that. That's why they say they want to fill the gap. That's what that means. It's not a certainty. If markets sell off, it's more vulnerable than the usual. So debit put spreads for somebody who wants to short it, that's great. And then there's this one. If it loses this one, then more negative things happen. And for that, I need to zoom out. Let's say maybe 2 years. Yep. This is that level, that red level right here. So if it loses that level, after this red circle loses that level, then this level will come into view. And then what? So if market's correct, it's really vulnerable. It will need, in my opinion, a headline in order to recover its upward bias or recent highs. That is Netflix. XLF, which represent the financial sector, going along it as suggested on 130, I said here, first of all, there was a breakout, then never mind. I said, well, right around here, maybe we should go long it for somebody who's bullish. So it would have paid nicely, and then correction. So the idea is if rates are rising, banks will be able to make more money. So XLF, it should be bullish XLF. Okay. So on the downside, I'm watching this green. I don't want it to break that. And I want to watch currently here how it handles that green bar. If it breaks out above it, you know, all-time highs are within reach, especially if they do hike the rates, because that might be a... So they wanted to do a credit put spread, which is a bullish position. I'm not willing to take it after this run, and if I do, I want to look to be down here and make it worth my while. So if I can find the premiums, I'll do it. Otherwise, I'll wait for confirmation of the breakout, then I'll get more aggressive with it. Until then, I hold it. And Google, it's still deciding whether it wants to hold this or not. I'm going to extend it. Yes, look, it's right on it. We poked it, but we're still on it. So what happens now? Because look, we have... Okay, where is it? Tightening ranges, those are dangerous. That means there's a lot of energy pent up, and it's going to have to move somewhere. So if anybody's moving, it's Google. If markets rocket tomorrow, Google will be at 570 probably sooner rather than later. If markets sell off, Google will revisit the low 500s. And this is the Goog, not the Google. Keep that in mind. So it's pretty important there. All right, folks, I'm not going to keep it long. It doesn't matter what we say right now. Tomorrow is what matters. We're going to open, and then we're going to get the Fed statement, and we're going to move on it. So most likely the open should be, unless there's a headline that tells us which way or another the Fed is going to talk. Until then, message me if you have any questions.